So, oh man, eager to get back to this one. So let's roll. So if I remember correctly, I've already done basically like an equipment check, but no reason to not quickly go through and have a look at all the things that I've got. It all seems fun. Alright. Oh wow, wind is really blowing. So before I head off looking for the old bear, I am gonna go by that lakeside cabin. Because I've got the Forest Talker gear, I've got their documents, and I kinda wanna see what sort of falls out of that. Three hours to get home when it normally takes one? Ouch. What was the issue with the trains? Something to do with, like, weather, or just, you know, somebody fucked up. Dear. Yeah, that'll do it. That is regrettable. On all counts. Doesn't help you had to carry a heavy bag. Oh, were you over the over the 30 kilograms? You pulling an old hidden distance, tromping through the snow? Man, I'm carrying too much. Haven't put much thought as to where I want to look for the old bear first. Some of the locations are safer than others, but, you know, just because they're safer doesn't mean that that's where it's going to be. Man, this wind, though. Alright. There's supplies and those documents you wanted here. Hey, that's great, thank you. But hey, I hope you understand if I ask you to just leave them outside the door. Sure, I get it. I'll leave everything here for you. Thank you, stranger. You may not care, but you made a huge difference to our cause. What the hell was that about? Jeez, minding my own business. Looking at my frickin' journal. Fucking wolf. Wonder if I have any. I could hear it coming like at the last minute, but I didn't know what direction. And by the time I was kind of ready for action, it was already too late. that sure was something. I guess what must have happened is that it must have been close, like around one of the cabins or something like that. And then by the time it saw me, I was already in like the kind of range at which it would aggressively attack me. Didn't take much damage in the way of condition. Wonder if any of my clothing got torn up. No, I mean, it all looks still about the same. That sprained wrist sucks, though. I'm gonna take a look at the camp office and see whether or not I have any more painkillers. If I don't, I might save them and just rest up. Oh no, you remember right. I was mauled by the old bear last night. Walked out of Jeremiah's cabin. I then panicked and went immediately back inside Jeremiah's cabin. And then ate something, drank something, slept the night, went outside, shot the bear in the face, and then it mauled me. So, you know, good times were had by all. And I have a list of locations to now go for where the bear is. Although I'm not going to look at the map right now, because apparently the game's out to get me. Bloody wolf. So, if I remember correctly, without having looked at the map, one of the locations was on top of the ridge, just by the trapper's cabin. So, like, just up the hill. One was at the pond. Another one was at the frozen creek. Another one was just south of the derailment. Another one at the clear cut, and another one at the logging camp. I think those were the locations that Jeremiah had marked. So, we're just gonna have to see. I suppose I could make tea, but then I'd have to start a fire. You know, for the painkillers. Which isn't the worst thing, your idea. But we'll see what I've got. I've got some more painkillers. I'll take those with me. And I'll take, I didn't need to do that. I'll take a couple right now. And then, yeah, we'll go from that. God, the antiseptic is so heavy. I should really make some bandages out of the beard lichen to save on weight. Okay. So. That's better. So, yeah. One up here, south of the derailment. Frozen Creek. There's this ridge I was talking about. One right by the homestead. Okay, so it wasn't the unnamed pond. But there is one in the clear cut. And there is one at the logging camp. So this one seems kind of dangerous, just given, like, the hilly area. This one's a little easier to see things, so is the frozen creek. Clear cut's easier to see, and the logging camp, too. So out of the locations, this one's the most dangerous. This one's the closest by, but I don't remember seeing it. But I think it would be pretty efficient if I went up here, and then kind of tucked around this way. From the frozen creek to the clear cut to the logging camp. So it might be worthwhile starting down here and then going up this way. Because I'll be able to check this basically on my way past the camp office and then, you know, kind of march through the woods in the hilly area over here. So, we will, yeah, we'll see. One out of six bear encounters. I hope that doesn't mean, you know, me getting mauled by a bear 6 times, because I'm not sure I'd be a big fan of that. That's right. I never actually did read up on the places entries, but that is not what I am up to right now. It's actually pretty astonishing how little condition damage I took in that wolf fight. I mean, it's not really like I have extraordinary gear. I guess the difficulty settings kind of tie into that. Or something. I mean, sure enough, I was using the hatchet, which is a great weapon to fight off a wolf. In my experience, it's not as good at, like, straight up killing a wolf, or at least quickly. Like, they don't bleed out that quickly, or necessarily all the time with the hatchet, I've found. But the hatchet seems to scare them off really good. And for me, that's what I'm looking for in a struggle. I want to get the wolf off me as soon as possible, and the hatchet's pretty good for that. I also found that the hammer is good for that too, but the hammer's a really heavy tool, and I don't use it for basically anything, you know? I mean, it's one of those things where it's like, okay, fair enough, you know? Maybe good for that, and, you know, in case I just happen to wind up at a forge and need to do some forging. But the hatchet has plenty of other uses. Okay. How long does it take me to craft one of these things? 15 minutes? I might hold off on making them. But I'll grab a few. Alright. So there's the radio tower. I'm actually going to be pretty close to the frozen creek here.
I need to find food.
No bear, as far as I can tell. I actually just had a thought. I don't know whether or not. Okay. Okay, there's the pond. So it's a little bit further down over here. Hey, Indy. How you doing? This damn wind. Cold, but all right. Damn. I don't know if I was hearing things, but I thought I could hear like a growling coming from the other side of this ridge. Could just be my footfalls in the snow, but. This wind is not helping. There's the bear. How's my aim?
Feels like an empty pit.
Damn it! Great. bitch. Two out of six. This isn't the way that this quest is seriously going to go, is it? Like, get mauled by the bear six times? Yeah, and now my gear is taking like another beating.
Could end up being useful.
Crap. So I need to repair that, that clothing item for my head. I mean, on top of that, the weather's really turning. I mean, I'm tempted to just follow the damn thing and, like, try and look for another part. I could survive another mauling. But, like, my gear won't, you know? And I don't want to be out here in nasty weather like this and get frostbite. Just because, you know, I'm like, well, you know, maybe the rest of it's going to go better or something. So, I really hope that this isn't what this quest is all about. I mean, The Hunted Part 2 was kind of like this, only when I shot the bear in The Hunted Part 2, the bear would actually run off. But that certainly does not seem to be the case here. And it's not like I have some easy place that I can escape to. You know, if there's like a car nearby or a building or something like that, you could actually just shoot the bear and then get inside the car. It's something that works. But yeah, if I'm just gonna get mauled over and over and over again, this is kind of dumb. So I suppose what I'll wind up doing. Yeah. I think what I'll wind up doing, I'll go back to the camp office. And I'll grab one of the sewing kits and some of the cloth. And then I can just have it around. And then can kind of go from there. Something along those lines. Plus, I might need a few more bandages if this is the case. But it's kind of stormy outside, so I might just spend the night here. I don't know, maybe I'm doing something wrong. I remember, you know, sort of at the beginning of the quest or whatever. What was it that Jeremiah had said? You know, like, wait until you can see the whites of his eyes or something? And I shot from, like, a lot further off. My second shot, I kind of waited until it was a little bit closer, but... But that really didn't seem to do much difference. So... I don't know. I guess we'll figure it out.
I think my stomach is eating itself.
That's not what I think. I think that is going to give me an opportunity to kind of check. The next two likely locations are going to be the unnamed, the creek, like the frozen creek, and the spot on the railroad. These two. I'm gonna be right there anyway. Since I need to fix my hat. At the very least. It would be one thing if, you know, one of my clothing items, like one of my pants, was like, oh, that's kind of wrecked, but my other set of pants was fine. Because then it's... Sure, you know, having clothing items ruined is not ideal, because, you know, that's cold. But, But the problem with losing my, my toque right now is that it's... like, one of my only hat items. And I don't want to get frostbite. Hey, Chops. If a bear shits in the wood and I'm around to see it, does he take the shot? You betcha. I'm not sure I'd have enough time to switch between the rifle and the flare gun. You know? So, like, if I shoot it from some range away, and then switch to the flare gun in an effort to sort of scare it off while it's charging, might be worth a shot. But swapping them out is... Like, I'm... You know, it's almost 5 seconds until I'm able to ready a shot. Which is, slow. Really slow. Kind of a shame. Okay then. Hello. I was saying it's kind of a shame now that I've started the hunt here that the weather has turned for the worse. It's not exactly a blizzard or anything, but not what you'd call bright and sunny either. I should probably just eat some of this deer meat, so I don't stick out so much. Okay. Okay. So. Also, it is heavy. Yeah, I'll go ahead and eat it. And I need... Did I put the cloth in, like, a specific location? Yeah, here's 8. And then we'll grab... two of the better toolkits, or toolkits that are in, you know, better condition at this point. Okay. So. So let me warm up. Maybe the weather will change a little bit. Pants are in much worse condition, so we'll fix them up. That's 2. My boots are in really crappy condition now as well. And my military coat. Ah, I knew I had some cured leather in here. This is gonna take forever to... Oh no, 25 minutes isn't too bad. And then, yeah, this is down a bit. So. And my gloves. Cripes. So, how much would I be taking out with me? 4? Come on, I know there's some socks under there. These things will be really quick to tear up. And these. Good. So that gives me 10.
I need some water.
10 things of cloth. All right. Time to go look for another spot with this damn bear. So I'm gonna look for it at the Frozen Creek area. So, let's see the bear here. There's one other thing that kind of bothers me about the repeated maulings. I mean, I'm 2 for 2 right now. Who knows if that's going to continue. Is that it's kind of, how to put it? it's in consonant with the other stuff that's happening in, like, the story mode, right? So, one of the things that's been happening, you know, with Grey Mother and with Jeremiah's survival school and that sort of thing is that it's... and even the start of the game, you know, when you crash out of the plane and then you're like, oh man, I gotta do these things. Like, it's a bit of a tutorial, right? It's teaching you, you know, some basic survival skill type stuff and, you know, what you can do, what you need to do, all of that sort of thing, right? And it's kind of cool because it teaches you the sorts of skills you'll need to survive in the sandbox, you know, if that's what you're interested in going on and playing. But, the severity of these bear maulings are not anywhere near what they are in the survival mode. So it's almost kind of teaching you that, you know, hey, getting attacked by a bear isn't that bad, when in fact getting attacked by a bear is like, you know, really bad. Oh boy, here we go again. Also, I don't know if I said so, but thanks for the lexicon backslash. I have a feeling I'm gonna need it. That was a hit. It's still scary to you and you're just watching. Yeah. Not my favorite. Watching the bear coming down at you. Well, here we go. Oh shit, yeah, here we go indeed. Fuck! No, it's just the... Oh, that's four of six. All right.